So it's a real joy to be here today. Thank you for coming. Today, every time I do a training day, I mean, this is the Property Millionaire Intensive. To become a millionaire, you need to make money. And to make money, you know, to become a property millionaire, not only do you need to make money, but you also need to know how to invest money. You know, I'm going to make sure that today I try my best to just give you everything. I'm not going to hold back today. I'm not going to hold information. I'm not going to, you know, teach you just a little bit and then deliberately leave things out. And, you know, I'm not going to do that. I'm going to give you as much as I possibly can. I'm going to go on the computer live and I'm going to show you how I find live BRR deals today in 2022. I'm going to show you how to package those deals and pitch the deals to investors. How to raise finance. How to sell those deals and make money in minutes as a deal seller. How to control properties. How to really make money in this business. You want a problem that scares the shit out of people. It scares people if the property, if it's got no hot water running. If there's no hot water in a property, now this is not a big fix. If a property has got no hot water in place, if the boiler's broken, but beyond repair, how much does it cost to get a new boiler? How much? $12.50. Good, you just bought one yesterday. Congrats. $12.50. So £1,250. Is that a lot of money, guys? No. Well, some people might think, yeah, okay. All right, $12.50. If you've got a property and this property has got a boiler and the boiler is broken and the boiler is beyond repair, that means you can't fix it, you have to get a new one. No lender will give a mortgage on that property. Isn't that weird? So you can't get a mortgage on a property just because the boiler's broke? Correct. So what does that mean? That means that you need to find a property for sale that's got no hot water in place. Why? Because then all the competition, first-time buyers, buy-to-let landlords, they are not able to get finance on this property. And 90% of purchases are done so with a mortgage. What does that mean? That means you can offer what you want. Because right now you guys are going to estate agents and saying, oh, I'm looking for a cheap deal, I'm looking for a bargain, and getting laughed out the agency. Because they're going, oh, join the queue. So what you need to do is you need to find properties that are problematic properties that nobody wants, and then you're only competing with other property developers. You're only competing with other people who are looking to buy the property and fix it up. And that's only 10% because they have to buy it cash. And most people don't have the cash because most people don't know where to get the cash from. But you know how to get the cash and you know where to get the cash from. Because I'll tell you something, everyone, oh, I ain't got money. You have. You still have it in your bank right now. You got it. But if you found some deals over lunch, you can pitch them to us. I might even be investing in some deals. I am actively looking for deals right now. How many would like to maybe do a joint venture with me? Raise your hand and say, aye. Amazing. This is about two things, okay? This is about training yourself to be the best, and this is about being unashamed to pitch deals and get uncomfortable. Does this make sense, guys? Yes or no? Give them a hand for their courage. There you go.
There's 21,000 for the guide price. And we've
right.
Added 10% for to hit the reserve. And then we've added 20K for refurbishment.
Okay.
It needs a bit of work.
Yeah, it needs quite a bit.
Yeah.
But structurally, it seems quite out.
What are you guys thinking? So it's on as a guide price of 29, yeah. Right? But you're saying you're gonna have to pay more than that because that's like
we gotta do it up.
Yeah,
you gotta do it up. So how much are you assuming that you're gonna be able to buy this property for?
We're assuming 32k.
Okay, well that I mean 32k. How likely do you think it is that you're gonna be able to buy this property in Birmingham for 32k? I mean, it's possible, but it's not. It, there's no guarantee you're gonna be able to get it for 32k, because sometimes I might list it at 29, it might sell for 60.
We allow
10% to be. Okay. Yeah, 10% is the reserve price.
Yeah, that's what we
allow. Yeah. All right, so let's assume that you buy it for 40 then.
We buy it for
40. All right, so the purchase price, let's assume it's 40. Now, of course, there's no guarantee they're going to sell it for 40. Yes or no, guys? But let's assume we buy it for 40.
We can go as
high as 80.
Oh, as high as 80. So what you would do, you'd buy this pre-auction. You'd ring up and you'd say, hey, I want to put forward an offer. It's a cash offer. I don't want you to sell it at auction. I'll buy it for £80,000 cash. That's how you do it. So let's say you buy it for 80 then. I mean, there's a very good chance they would accept £80,000 cash. Would you agree, guys? Yes or no?
Yes.
A very good chance, but no guarantees. You're saying it's going to be 20 grand for the refurb. Let's have a look at the pictures. I mean, the garden alone is going to cost you a couple of grand just to get that sorted. It is elbow grease, it is. I mean, you could do it yourself, but I mean, this looks like some serious, this looks. All right, well, we'll get to the end bay in a minute. This is gonna cost, the cosmetics are only gonna cost 10, 15 grand, but what I'm worried about is electrics, we can't see the roof. It looks like it's potentially gonna need, I mean, at very least, it's gonna need to be re-rendered. At very least, I'm thinking you're probably talking at about 25 grand to get this property looking good. So if you buy it for 80 and you spend 25 on it, that means that all in all, you're talking £105,000. Big question is, what's the end value?
Between 134 and 140.
Okay, well, let's have a look to see if that's correct. So, if we get the postcode, which is B676BW, we're gonna go to house prices and we're gonna see what's sold in the street. So they're saying 100, how much did you say, sorry?
130 to 140.
Between 130 and 140. Let's have a look within quarter of a mile. Well, these are expensive. We got like 230, 185, 110, 238, 125. I'd say the, a like-for-like property would be probably a little bit like this one. It's quite small.
Yeah.
This sold for 136,500.
Yeah.
Yeah, we've got one on the same road,
yeah.
Number 81.
Yeah.
For 140.
Yeah.
I mean, this one sold for 152.
Yeah.
And that sold in this year, 2021.
Yeah,
so this property all depends. Sorry, not this one. This property in Birmingham, it all depends on what we could get the offer accepted for. It all depends on whether they'd accept a pre-auction offer. So really what you need to do is we need to phone the agent up and say, will they be willing to accept a really juicy cash pre-auction offer and find out. So who's gonna make that call?
Well,
all right, well, you need to do it now. Pick up the phone, let's hear what they say. Should we give him a hand for some courage, by the way, guys?
Yeah.
All right. There's viewings on it, 1st of February, that's next week, 11 o'clock. So what I would be doing is I'll be going to the viewing, I'll be pricing up that refurb. And then I'll be just thinking, right, I know exactly what I can offer. Maybe it's 80, maybe it's 70. And then I'd go and bid at the auction or wait for it not to sell at the auction and then go in straight after. It's not a deal, but it's a very juicy lead. So, personally, really like that. You say you're going to the auction on the 1st of Feb?
Why not?
All right, well, I'll make you an offer, okay? You've got two options right now. Option number one is you can just go ahead and you can go and view it at the auction and try and turn that hot lead into a hot deal. Option number two is you can just be like, hey, Samuel, I found this hot lead and I'll go do the viewing next week. And I'll take that off you and you will receive £100 each. Now, of course, this is a big decision. It's a juicy big lead on the table, right? That could turn into a deal. It could make a lot of money. As it happens, it's on my patch. So, guys, hold on, guys. Don't worry, I'm gonna give you a chance to have a meeting, all right? We're all good. I'm gonna first explain to you the proposition, then you guys are gonna get a chance to have a meeting. So here's the two options. Option number one is you can receive £100 cash each, £300. And then I'm going to go and take over the auction viewing, and it's basically my lead. And you can say, thank you very much. Option number two is you can just keep the lead, and you can go ahead and try and turn it into a deal yourself, and then you can then sell it for 3,000, or you can keep it and buy it yourself. Those are the two options. Who's the team leader? You're the boss. And what's your name?
I'm Rachel.
Rachel. So Rachel, after you've had a chance to have your meeting, you're going to have to let me know. So you're going to have a chance to have a meeting about this. I'm going to give you guys a chance to have a 15 second meeting about this, which starts now.
Good civilization.
Yeah. All right, so guys, let me ask you a question. What would you do? Would you take the money or would you keep the deal? Money or deal? Come on, money or deal? All right, drum roll, everybody, drum roll! And go ahead, what do you want? All right, head back to your seats. Head back to your seats. Let me ask you a question, guys. How many of you have realized how powerful it is when you learn to find good deals? Yes or no? The first thing you need to master is you need to master the art of taking massive action. What's the word, please?
Action.
Twice as loud.
Action.
Thank you. You've got to take massive action. Like, literally, the difference between people that become millionaires and billionaires and people that just sit at home watching Netflix, doing nothing, the difference between them are the wealthy and the successful people just take action. They go places that most wouldn't go. They do things that most wouldn't do. Did you guys see when I had the mystery box?
Yeah.
You saw I had a mystery box? I'm like, hey, I got a mystery box. Does anybody want to give me a pound for the mystery box and the contents, what's inside? And I tell you something, everybody ran from me like I was a leper.
Yeah.
They were like, whoa, this dude's trying to sell to me. They were so afraid of being sold to that they missed the opportunity. They were so afraid of investing a pound. Because most of them didn't even listen to what I had to offer. They were just like, no, thank you. And then literally after about 3 or 4 hours, I remember going into a Starbucks. I'm like the cashier's there. I'm like, hey, man. I said, you're interested in my mystery box? He said, no, thank you, sir. I said, come on, man, it's only a pound. He goes, nah, thank you. I said, what's the worst case? You'll lose a pound. What's the best case? Could be something really valuable. Come on, brother. And he looked at me and he was just like, okay. He pulls his card out and I scan his card and his card declines for whatever reason. Okay, and I was like, man, your card's declined. He goes, don't worry, I'm gonna go and find a pound. He went and got a pound. He gives me the pound, and I gave him the box. He opens it up. He saw £1,000 cash. He's like, whoa. And I said, you deserve that, man. Respect for just having a little faith. And, people said, that was a setup, man. He was a friend or something. Not stage, not setup. The guy was a complete stranger. However, that guy is actually here in the room today. So, Tim, respect, my brother. Let me just shake your hand one more time, man. Let me just shake your hand one more time, man. Can we show some love to Tim? Can we show some love to Tim? Yeah! So Tim got £1,000 richer. Then he was like, who the f*** is this dude, man? So he finds me on YouTube and now he ends up here.
My name is Tim and I met Samuel at Pret. If you guys remember the video he posted on YouTube, he came into my store, offered me a box for £1. And I gave him the £1, and I opened the box later, and there was £1,000. So I decided to come and see what it's all about, and I enjoyed every bit of today. It was almost from 96, and it felt like it was a couple of minutes, and I learned so much. I had £1,000, right? I took 100 out, I gave it to church, and 900 is literally just sitting there. Like, I got 900, yeah, literally just sitting there. I definitely plan on taking action and leaving Pret. And you know, just working for myself and hopefully giving back the same way I was given too. Samuel, he's just so energetic. Like you can feel every, it was like from nine, imagine I've been here from 9 to 6 and it has felt every single time it's spoken. It has felt, even though hours have been by like only minutes, he has so much energy. He speaks so much truth and he knows what he's talking about. You don't just make 20 million from, you know, I feel energized. I feel, you know, and I haven't really ate. So that's a lot of energy, and I eat a lot for not eating at all. And I'm still here from 9 to 6. I love it. My biggest takeaway of today is that you have to take action. I actually won 100 pounds today again because I took action, and I believe that you can know and learn so much, but if you don't take action, you're really not doing anything. So yeah, get the knowledge, but take action, and trust me, anything is possible.
You gotta look at this, you gotta say, look, if I'm taking action, you gotta do this, you gotta say, what is the best case scenario, and what is the worst case scenario? If the best case scenario is, man, I could win £1,000, £1,000,000, I could be financially free, change my life forever, but the worst case is, oh, it's gonna cost me £1 or £1,000 or, you know, you gotta weigh it up, man. You gotta weigh up the best versus the worst. And once you've weighed up the best versus the worst, then you've just gotta do something called taking action. This is not just about finances. This is everything. What you believe about yourself is really important. Because you will back up your own beliefs and you will find the evidence to back up your current beliefs. I thought I was stupid because my teachers told me I was stupid. And because my teachers told me I was stupid, I believed I was stupid. And because I believed I was stupid, I was stupid. This is so important. Let me explain. If you think that you're a loser, believe me, you'll find the evidence to back up your point. If you believe you're a winner, you'll find the evidence to back up your belief. Yeah. Thank you, my brother. And if you're not around people that believe in you and pull you up, then you need, this is the last point. And man, this is huge. Fourth thing is environment. Some people think they need more discipline, man. You don't need more discipline, you need better friends. Some people think that they need more willpower. Get up in the morning and make those calls and psych himself up. You don't need more willpower. You don't need more why power. You need a new environment because environment is stronger than willpower. If you grow up in Australia, how are you going to talk with an Australian accent? Why? Because everybody around you is speaking with the Australian accent. It'd be weird if you speak like with an English accent. Because that's not who you're around. If you're spending time hanging around people that are smoking, you're going to smoke. You're hanging around people that are doing property deals and are financially free. It becomes the new normal and you do the same. You know, if it wasn't for the people in my life, my mom, who didn't give me money, but she did give me belief. She believed in me. And me and my mom do deals to this day. She's also now in property. You know, the people that believed in me and opened doors, really, if it wasn't for those people, I wouldn't be able to be where I am today. And, you know, these four things, if you get all of these, action, knowledge, belief, environment, keep yourself around the right people, I tell you something, you're destined to succeed. Don't forget today. You know, don't forget today. When you go and get deals and you start making a success of property, let me know. Inbox me, man. Hit me up.